Dear friends of the Tom Photo channel, I recently created a video where I compare two popular Nikon kit lenses, the AF-S DX NIKKOR 18-55 GVR2 and the AF-P NIKKOR 18-55 GVR. I decided to refer to them as AF-S and AF-P. In that video, the AF-P emerged as the winner in the battle of the kit lenses by just 1 point, and I concluded that both lenses were very nice. You can find that video linked below. However, one thing I did not do in that video, but I promised to do, was to compare the absolute sharpness, not relative sharpness, of these two lenses. I am now keeping my promise, and today I will address that specific question. We know that the sharpness profiles of the AF-S and AF-P are quite different, especially at the wide angle end. Good sharpness extends to a relatively large range of f-stops for the AF-S. But which one of these lenses is sharper in absolute terms? I placed both lenses in front of my Nikon D3400 and photographed a plywood board from 80 centimeters away. The camera was securely fixed to the tripod with all buttons and screws of the Velbon VideoMate 638 tightened to the maximum, and the tripod was additionally taped to the floor to ensure stability. I took every precaution to ensure nothing moved when I carefully changed the lenses. All settings were identical for both lenses, with vibration reduction turned off, and I used the self-timer to take the photos. The shutter speed was set at 30, ISO to 800, and the f-stop to 11 for all photos. Why 11, you might ask? Because as shown in my first video, this is the sweet spot for both lenses. Doing this side-by-side comparison at any other f-stop would be less informative, as the lenses function differently at other f-stops. I took photos at 18mm, 35mm and 55mm for both lenses. Each photo was repeated a total of 12 times using single focus mode. I then measured the sharpness of all photos as demonstrated in my previous videos, links provided below, and I ended up with 12 data points for each lens and each focal length. I now removed the three lowest valued data points and averaged the remaining ones to obtain the average sharpness value. Why remove the three least sharp data points? This is done to reduce variation, assuming that about 25% of the shots might be imperfectly focused due to occasional autofocus misses. This precaution ensures a more accurate representation. Here are the results. You can compare the absolute values between the lenses, but only at the same focal length, as zooming in and out changes the subject. Note the tiny error bars above the colored bars, representing standard deviations. Their magnitudes are very small, indicating experiment's reliability. The results are remarkable, showing significant differences between the two lenses. At the wide-angle end, they display similar sharpness. At 35mm, the AF-P is significantly sharper. As we reach 55mm, the tables turn and the AF-S becomes sharper, a conclusion we can state with confidence. Deciding which lens is better is not straightforward. Many photographers, for example, capture images at 35mm, which corresponds to 50mm on a full-frame sensor and is considered a natural focal length similar to what our eyes see. On the other hand, I often find myself using 55mm as it brings me closer to the subject, and most subjects seem too far away for me. You see, I'm not predominantly a wide-angle photographer. Which lens do you prefer? It is challenging to say that one lens is better. They are just different. Thank you so much for watching. If you found value in this content, I kindly ask you to consider subscribing to my channel and leaving a like. These actions will greatly support me. Enjoy your photography until the next time. Goodbye.